Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. And in today's video, as you saw by the thumbnail and title of the video, we are doing Identity V, or I'm pretty sure it's Identity 5. But it's from NetEase. They made Rules of Survival. They make great games. They made Life After a game. That's probably next video. Life After, it's an amazing game, and it's a survival game, this game is Identity 5. This is my first time playing it ever, and I just recorded it, right? First time playing it ever, and you're a detective, alright? You're a detective, and you have to figure out this whole case, and this is episode one. More to come, alright? Hope you guys are going to enjoy the video. If you do, leave a like, subscribe, hit the bell to get notified every time I upload a new video, and guys, enjoy the video. I'll see you in a little bit. Alright guys, so we are in the game Identity 5, or Identity V. I'm pretty sure that's the Roman numeral for 5, so I'm calling it Identity 5. You can call it Identity V, I don't really care. But here we go.
My name is Zolfius, once a novelist, but after losing my memory, I couldn't complete any valuable writing. Now I'm just a private detective with my clients. Until I received a strange request. Investigate an infamous estate and find a man's lost daughter. Besides the check, it was the name on the letter that intrigued me. Not Orpheus, but...
Oh, here we get to enter our name. Spencer Witt. Name is already in use.
That almost nobody knew but me.
Scene one, let's get a new order. I mean, this is a sort of a little creepy game, but it's like not really that creepy. After nearly half a day on the road, I have finally arrived at the manor mentioned in the commission letter. Due to the unexpected storm, the dilapidated main house and the huge manor became my first destination. As I entered the main house, I found that most of the rooms inside were in disrepair due to years of neglect. The rain and cold kept urging me to leave this place until I opened the door of the living room.
Somewhere that's been deserted for 10 years. This room's in remarkable condition. I think I'll stay here for the night.
Will you stay?
But it's too dark in here. I need to find an alternate light source before the fuel in this lantern runs out. Thank God. Candles here still burn. There should be some more on the wall.
The footsteps.
I know it's all psychological. These candles really calm the nerves.
A strange squeak. What the heck?
Paper airplane? Something that children usually play with.
This is getting creepy.
Someone was probably playing around and it got caught up there. Then, a rat, scared by the light, shook it from the lamp. Who made it, though? This is what I can deduce from my initial analysis. The paper used might actually contain some information from which I might find other clues.
Oh.
This looks like a page from a diary. Interesting. The date is from several days ago. The person who wrote this is most likely connected with our missing person. Although I can't write anymore, I still have an uncanny ability to sense the emotions of a text. This is an ability most people do not possess.
All right.
By reading the text, I can attempt to reconstruct the scene and even find out information about the author.
Do I start case restoration?
Description mentioned an attic attached to the main house, located some distance away. I think we are still at the manor, but it seems we're some distance from the main house. For now, I need to focus and retrace the steps of our mystery author.
What is that?
I should probably drink less.
What is that?
Judging from the content, my guess would be that our author is male, right-handed, and of average education.
Does he see this? I have to follow the figure.
From here onwards, the writing becomes even more wild and illegible. Fear is stripped of his ability to describe his encounter with any logic, as if something was hunting him.
I caught up, but unfortunately this is decoded a cipher machine. That went way too fast in the tap. Oh my poor guys. Oh. We need to hurry and find the last cipher machine, alright? The server's object is decoded a specific number of cipher machines. Drag the camera upwards to look for glowing antennas and locate cipher machines. Alright, this is one. Let's decode it. Dude, this is insane. Why didn't he come after us? Anyways, wow. Plus, these are going to be like long episodes. I'm not really going to do too much.
Diary editing. Suddenly stops here. What on earth does that mean? Carnival. It reads like something that was written by a lunatic. I really hope that Mr. Reichenbach's daughter is not involved in this.
Reichenbach's?
What I really need to do now is find the rest of the diary. Find out what's happened here. There should be other clues among these sheets of paper.
Alright.
black powder seems to be charcoal. The answer is probably close by. There happens to be a fireplace here.
Let's go to the fireplace.
There's charcoal in the fireplace, but no diary. That's not surprising. But something else has attracted my attention. The unburned firewood.
Ooh.
The chimney has been sealed off. Seems the owner didn't use the fireplace, and its true purpose remains unclear.
This detective's good.
There must be some more clues around here.
Alright, let's follow the footprints.
This candlestick is... I think I know why there's an extra candle here. It's firmly attached to the fireplace. Seems to actually be a part of the fireplace. This is pretty important.
What does that mean? Check it. Oh, what? Oh. This wall starts to slowly rotate. This is absolutely insane. My eyes are so. This goes so fast, I can't read it. Scene 2, the clue. Oh, my God. When the walls start rotating, about 100 books that look almost exactly the same came into focus. Intuition told me that the page that I was holding in my hand came from one of these books. And it was the simple fact that astounded me.
I used to detest bedtime reading when I was a child. Trying to find a diary with a missing page in here is like looking for a needle in a haystack. The search for one specific diary is no longer important. All of these diaries are significant.
That's a lot of books. That's a lot of diaries. Because I don't really want to read it.
I have never seen anything so odd. It is obvious that these entries were not written by the same person, which means that they were insane, or something else happened here that I do not yet understand. They've raised more questions than they have answered. It seems I shall have to apply a somewhat archaic method to obtain the information that I need.
Alright, let's start the case restoration again. Arms Factory. Come on. Boom, let's get it. We escape. Yeah, new memory.
All right. I think I can catalog the particulars of all the authors into profiles based on the information I've found.
Alright. Your profiles will help with any analysis. It's not possible to recover any more details using animals, unless you have to do any more specific characters to expand the profile. Where do I go now? Look for clues on the shelf.
The contents of a few scattered diaries is connected. I think they're describing the same game. According to this entry, the author describing this game is a doctor.
What?
The entry from this doctor is more detailed and complete. I think this would be a good place to begin.
But I hate being... What? Three teammates escaped from the hunter. Go and heal her. Where's she at? Tap record on the screen shows. Thief person. Okay, let's go. Let's go heal. Decode this cipher machine. Let's decode it. Oh, it's gonna take a while. This is not good. Perfect. Come on, brother, I need your help. Come on, dude. This game is so nerve-wracking. We're almost done, come on. Oh my gosh! Guys, I kind of need help. I helped you guys. What is going on here? Yes. Right, where do we need to go? Two more ciphers remaining? I was so close. What just... Where am I going? Run over there. Come on, doctor. I really need an Unicode. Oh, there's only one remaining. Where's that? So slow with the password. What's that glowing thing over there? Look at her eyes. Oh my gosh. What? Right, let's go. Let's escape. Run. That was so close.
As for the hunter, I'm still not clear about his role in this game, but he has what I'm looking for. Perhaps it would be better if I try to approach the problem from another person's perspective.
No, I don't want to do that again. I don't want to do this. Just need to recover their strength. I'm not even gonna cheer for that. I didn't want to do that. Got a new character.
It would seem that the rules don't apply to the hunter. The hunter has hindered everyone since the beginning, regardless of their actions. But how was it that no one resisted the hunter? Was it because of the hunter's strength, or has everyone simply yielded to the hunter's dominance? Does the hunter take pleasure in this game? Or to put it another way, is that the real purpose of this game? It is ironic that the emergence of the hunter has forced this group of people, who had opposing interests in the beginning, to work together. I need to find out more about the situation. The information on the hunter is key. I need to know what he wanted to do next. Technique, patterns, disposition, traits, everything.
Through VPN rails and generation. It's so fast. So I just X out. Check the diaries and deduce the 100 details to acquire Survivor's Leaf. Actually, I'm not going to do that. This is a small episode, so only like around 25 minutes, but like, that's it for this episode, alright? Because this game is so fun, and I don't know when I'm going to play it next, but this is episode number one. We're going to do episode number two in a couple days, probably. It's probably not going to be the next video, but probably a couple days. Alright? Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like. Subscribe if you're new. Hit the bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. And guys, I'll see you next time. Peace.